A very good afternoon to one and all. In this particular video, we are going to discuss about what do you mean by attrition management. If you are joining at a level of a manager or a team manager, where your responsibility involves managing a group of people, this question is a definite question. As Ajim Premji, the chairman of Wipro, rightly said, people leave managers, not companies. Hence, it is very important for recruiters to understand your people management skills, and to understand your people management skills, they ask you this question. They wanted to know how regularly you stay connected with your teams and study their pulse to detect any kind of sensors you receive so that you can understand their dissatisfaction and work and provide a solution to that on a proactive basis. And when you provide them a solution in a proactive way, there are more likely chances to retain them and avoid attrition. There are two types of attrition. One is a positive attrition, that is a healthy attrition, and second one is a unhealthy attrition. When your top performers, your top cream in your team leaves you, that is an unhealthy attrition. However, when you have a bottom performers or low performers who decide to leave you and go to the competitors, that is a very healthy sign for you. The reason being, you have an opportunity to hire better people, top up your talent pool with better resources. So this way, attrition management can be classified into good and bad. Now, how do you calculate the attrition percentage formula? This is something you need to know when you go for a mid-level interview. Attrition is calculated as number of people leaving the particular team by average headcount in that particular team in that particular month into 100. So why do you take an average? The reason being, in the start of the month, say you have 100 people. Towards the closing of the month, last day of the month, you have 200 people. And if you are taking 100 people, then your attrition will go very, very, very high. If you are taking 200, then your attrition will be very, very less. It's a huge variance. To reduce that variance and give you the most relevant figure, you take an average of that. For example, starting count was 100, ending count is 200. 100 plus 200 by 2 will give me 150. So 15 people are leaving. 15 by average headcount, that is 150 into 100. So that will give you 10% as your attrition percentage for that particular month. Similarly, attrition can be calculated for quarterly basis, half yearly basis, and annual basis. Be perfect with your basics when you attend for an interview, which requires you to talk about attrition management, and you need to talk about your retention strategies as to how would you retain your top talent by giving them better learning opportunities, taking care of them, giving a very good fun-filled environment. So talk about everything and anything that you do to ensure your top cream does not leave you and they want to stay connected with you throughout their journey. I hope you understood about attrition management. Have a nice day and take care.